The National Leadership Team's report, which is fairly hefty, I'm trusting many of you will have read that. That is on pages 19 to 24 of your commissioner's handbook. I am not going to go through all of that with you, but rather I'm going to do with you what we do at the beginning of every National Leadership Team meeting, which is to go over the mission and the vision statement of the EPC. The NLT has been described by some as the session of the denomination. That's not quite accurate. It's not an actual court of the church. It doesn't have that kind of authority. It's really a committee of this assembly that does the business of this assembly between its meetings. And so our charge is to ensure that the vision and mission of our denomination continues between the ruling of each assembly. And so we start out every meeting by reading our mission statement and reminding ourselves of what God has called us to do. So would you join me in reading our mission statement together? The EPC exists to carry out the Great Commission of Jesus as a denomination of Presbyterian, Reformed, Evangelical, and Missional congregations. Now, I won't go into great detail on any of these things. I'm trusting by now that we're in our second business meeting, you're getting a sense of how we do governance. We governed by the elders, teaching and ruling elders together. There is wisdom in the council of the godly. You know for a fact that we are reformed. If you didn't attend, for example, during the Leadership Institute, the Westminster Society has done a spectacular job of anchoring us and reminding us of our reformed tradition, this rich and deep heritage that is our theological tradition and faith. You're going to come tonight and commission missionaries as we hear Andrew Brunson again talk. We've heard Leon speak. We've heard Brad speak. We are filled with the good news of the gospel. Therefore, we are an evangelical body. But the one I would call your attention to ever so briefly is what it means for us to be missional. I don't have to say a great deal about that, because I will tell you that part of the stewardship and shepherding of the NLT is to come alongside of guys like Tom Ricks and say, Tom, how can we prioritize church planting in under-resourced communities so that we're reaching people for the gospel in our own backyards who do not yet know the gospel? And the Lake Forest church plant is a great picture of that. Or to come alongside of the 7-9 Commission and say, hey, how can we, all of our congregations, reach people in a 1, 3, and 5 mile radius of our churches? There are a lot of people in our own missional backyard who have yet to hear the gospel. And so really, that is our mission, and it's the NLT's job to keep us on mission. Now, second, I'd like for us to take a look at our vision statement real quickly, if we could, because this is a picture of a preferred future. It's aspirational. It's something that we hope that by God's grace and His Spirit, we would continue to grow into the reality of this. Would you read this out loud with me now, too? To the glory of God, the EPC family aspires to embody and proclaim Jesus' love as a global movement of congregations engaged together in God's mission through transformation, multiplication, and effective biblical leadership. If you leave that up on the screen, I'm going to go backwards. Biblical leadership. How many of you came earlier Tuesday and Wednesday were part of our great leadership institute? I think many of us think that that might be the finest and best part of our general assemblies, because we come and we receive the gifts and the tools to equip us to go home and serve, because we recognize that the front line of service is in those local congregations. And biblical leadership, under the excellent leadership of our assistant stated clerk, Jerry Iamuri, who shepherds that, has been one of our priorities. So the NLT says, Jerry, how's it going this year with the Leadership Institute? Who are you bringing in? Who do you suggest? How can we best equip the church? And he does an amazing, amazing job with that. Multiplication. Well, that's church planting. You've already heard from Tom Ricks, and you see that we are a denomination that has gone from being an aspiration to a movement. And we're known out there among church planters as the place to be, and our new renewed focus of reaching those people in our communities not yet reached for the gospel in under-resourced areas is an incredible opportunity for us. Oh, my goodness. Global movement. The most meaningful moment of the General Assembly for me is tonight. When our global workers come up on this stage after having heard from Andrew Brunson and we pray over them, you'll notice there's a vow in there where they're willing to be martyred for the gospel. Don't miss it. It's the most profound and meaningful moment of this entire week. But we work with World Outreach, and we are considering how we can continue to go to the hard places with the good news of Jesus Christ, including when God brings the nations to our doorsteps, like he did at Pentecost, and a fresh wind blows, and we find that the hard places might be in our own backyard. That global movement goes both ways. That's the vision of the EPC that this body voted on a number of years ago. That is our mission, and it is the job of the national leadership team to, on your behalf, shepherd and steward that vision. And by God's grace, if you read that report, you'll see there's a lot of other stuff that becomes a part of that too. But that's the stuff that jazzes us. That's the stuff that gets us on a plane and leaving all behind to go and give our time lovingly to this denomination, because we believe in our vision and we believe in the mission that God has given to the Evangelical Presbyterian Church. I'm honored to have served as the chair this last year, to have received that mantle from my friend, Scott Griffin, and to pass it on to my other friend, as Tom comes up and goes from a has-been moderator to the new chair of the National Leadership Team. Mr. Moderator, that concludes my report.